إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستهديه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه نثني عليه الخير كله نعبده ولا نشركه ولا نكفره ونترك ونخلع كل من يكفره ويزجره اللهم إياك نعبد ولك نصلي ونسجد وإليك نسعى ونحفد نرجو رحمتك ونخشى عذابك إن عذابك الجد بالكفار ملحق وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له شهادة شهد بها لنفسه وأقر بها في كتابه فقال إنني أنا الله لا إله إلا أنا فاعبدني وأقم الصلاة لذكري إن الساعة آتية أكاد أخفيها لتجزى كل نفس بما تسعى وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا ومعلمنا وقائدنا وأسوتنا رسول الخير سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين ومن اقتفى أثره وأثرهم واتبع هداه واستنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خيرة خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الله به الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فصلاة وسلاما دائمين متلازمتين عليك سيدي يا رسول الله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما Indeed, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek His help, we invoke Him, we ask Him to send the salutation upon the Prophet Muhammad. Peace and blessings upon him, his companions, his spouses, and whomsoever follows his footsteps until the end of time. I bear witness and testify that there is no one worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness and testify that the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings upon him, he's the final and the last messenger. I warn myself and advise myself before you all, and to be conscious and contemplate upon the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, upon the advice that He advised us in His glory book, who believed, people of iman, people of faith, people of taqwa, have taqwa in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and have the taqwa, and do not die except in the scale of Islam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant all of us a good end in this life and a good end in hereafter. All who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and all will say the truth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promises those who will say the truth, He will rectify and direct their affairs and forgive their sins. And whomsoever obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messenger, indeed, he will be among the winners in this life and hereafter. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among them. Allahumma ameen. My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, the topic that I would like to share with you in this blessed moment in our day, the day of Jumu'ah, as I was saying this in the morning, Salatul Fajri, خير أيام أو خير يوم طلعت فيه الشمس يوم الجمعة, the best day that the sunrise raised or came out is the day of Al-Jumu'ah. And يوم التذكرة, the day of the reminder that we come together to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to remind one another. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of us, Allahumma ameen. The topic, it is worship your Lord, worship Allah, worship God, and be patient with His obedience. The idea came from the ayah in Surah Maryam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, رب السماوات والأرض وما بينهما فاعبده واصطبر لعبادته هل تعلم له سميا. Patient, it mentioned in the Quran over 90 times. But this ayah telling us how to be patient with the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, emphasizing the oneness of God, the ability and the capability of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Almighty, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala control everything and everything in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and everything with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا. The Lord of heaven and earth and what is between both of them. فَاعْبُدُهُ O Muhammad, worship Allah. وَاصْطَبِرْ لِعِبَادَتِ And be patient with this ibadah, with this obedience, with this worship. هَلْ تَعْلَمُ لَهُ سَمِيَّةً And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked, did you know anyone equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Indeed, there is nothing equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the idea of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being patient with all of our obedience. أعبد الله, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with patience. Committing the salawat or performing the salawat with patience. Fasting with patience. Dealing with one another with patience. As-sabr. It is all required. When Luqman alayhi salam advised his son, يَا بُنَيَّ أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ وَأْمُرْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَانْهَى عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا أَصَابَكَ إِنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. A lot of obedience, a lot of matters that he advised his son to commit. يَا بُنَيَّ أَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ Establish the prayers. Perform the prayers. وَأْمُرْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ And let people join good and forbid evil. وَاصْطَبِرْ وَأْمُرْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَانْهَى عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا أَصَابَكَ And be patient with what is going to affect you. Rather is good or bad. إِنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ That indeed all of these matters require determination. Azima, azm. Be patient with all of these goodness and bad. Ulama, or the scholars and the fuqaha, they said there are too many types of patience. There is sabr ala ta'at. There are patience required with obedience. Wasabrun عَلَى الْمَحْظُورَاتِ And صَبْر Be patient with the disobedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَصَبْرٌ عَلَى الْمَقْدُورَاتِ And صَبْر Or being patient with the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which one is the highest? صَبْرٌ عَلَى مَأْمُورِ وَصَبْرٌ عَلَى مَحْظُورِ وَصَبْرٌ عَلَى مَقْدُورِ What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to do is require patience. وَصَبْرٌ عَلَى مَحْظُورٌ What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid us to stay away or forbidding us from doing it, require patience. وَصَبْرٌ عَلَى مَقْدُورٌ And being patient with the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or being patient with the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is require patience. Which one? Should we follow? All of them. But the highest, or as the scholars emphasize in these three categories, الاثنين الاولين, the first two, it is امر مكتسب, you train yourself to be patient with. والامر الاخير, the third one, which is the qadar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that comes, we don't have anything to deal with it. We have to be patient with it. It's a qadar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing require you to do except being patient with the qadar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants for us. الصبر على الابتلاء والصبر على المأمور. What is required patient in the first one, what is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to do, as Prophet or Luqman alayhi salam advised his son, Ya bunayya aqimi salah, oh my son, establish the prayer, wa'mur bil ma'roof wa nahy 'anil munkar. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us to do as believers. As-salah, the prayers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, and he says, وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. It's a great matters. And it is required a lot of patience. It is not easy to see someone come into the masjid and establish the five-time prayers. It is not easy. It is not. It is required patience. And it's a great matter, except those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they know the value of it. They know the importance of it. إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ, except those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala facilitated for them and made it easy for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of us, Allahumma ameen. Allahumma yassir alayna wa la tu'assir alayna ya rabbal alameen. May Allah make it easy for all of us, not make it difficult to all of us. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا لَا نَسْأَلُكَ رِزْقًا نَحْنُ نَرْزُقُكَ وَالْعَاقِبَةُ لِلتَّقْوَى. In another ayah, وَاصْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا وَلَا تَحْزَنْ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا تَكُ فِي ضَيْقٍ مِمَّا يَمْكُرُونَ. Being patient, what they are planning for. It's a qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of them. وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ إِنَّ ذَٰلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. When it comes to dealing with one another, when it comes to dealing with one another, families, spouses, husbands, children. What is the requirement? There is some argument. There is some issues. How am I going to deal with that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَمَنْ صَبَرْ, whomsoever will be patient with this matter. وَغَفَرْ, and he forgive or give excuses. Stubborn husband, stubborn wife. What do we have to do with that? Patient. It is not easy. It is easy to say, but it's hard to practice. وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرْ إِنَّ ذَٰلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. Among the great matters, when we deal with each other, to practice patience as well. My husband is rough. My wife, she's tough. What I have to do? I have to deal with hikmah and seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be among the grateful and then being patient. If it's not work, what I have to do? There is other steps that we have to work on it. But first, seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seeking patience, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us patience in this life and to make us among the sabireen. Why? When you look to the reward of each ibadah, rather to be among the mutawakkileen, among the sabireen, among الشاكرين, among الحامدين, and you can count on. You can count on being patient, being grateful, being a trustworthy person, being someone who is trusting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and put all of his affairs in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَتَوَكَّلُ عَلَيْهِ. Each of this ibadah, that there is a great reward in it. And this is what we have to do as believers, as Muslims. Being a shakir among those who are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything, major or little, minor or major, small or big. And being patient with the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want this for us. وَسَيَجْعَلُ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ عُسْرٍ يُسْرًا. This is our belief. How to strengthen yourself. Read the book of Allah. Go back to the book of Allah. Go to the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It has the self-reflection, the guidance. As the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فِيمَا مَعْنَى الْحَدِيثِ. The meaning, the beauty of this hadith. تَوْرَكْتُ فِيكُمْ مَا إِن تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِمَا لَن تَضِلُّوا بَعْدِي أَبَدَى كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَسُنَّتِي. I have left something for you to hold up to it. And if you hold to it, you will never be misled. The book of Allah and the guidance of the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you read the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you know, if I did so, if I practice gratefulness, practice patience, practicing the hamd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, magnifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I know that the reward in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what I'm going to lose? I'm not going to lose anything. You strengthen your faith, your aqeedah in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive our sins and to shower all of us mercy. يَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفُرُ اللَّهَ الْعَظِيمَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلاما على عباده الذين اصطفى محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اقتفى. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل على محمد في الآخرين وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين صلاة ترضى بها عنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. What dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَمَنْ يَتَصَبَّرْ يُصَبِّرُهُ اللَّهِ وَمَا أُعْطِيَ أَحَدًا عَطَاءً خَيْرًا وَأَوْسَعُ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ وَمَنْ يَتَصَبَّرْ يُصَبِّرُهُ اللَّهِ وَمَا أُعْطِيَ أَحَدًا عَطَاءً خَيْرًا مِنَ الصَّبْرِ. When you talk about someone who is good, a person that he is really good, have good personality or has good character, if you want to give a good word about him, he's patient. He's so calm. He's good to deal with him. He's easy coming, easy going. وَمَنْ يَتَصَبَّرْ يُصَبِّرُهُ اللَّهِ. Whomsoever looking to be patient or seeking patience, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant him patience. وَمَا أُعْطِيَ أَحَدًا خَيْرًا أَوْ عَطَاءً خَيْرًا مِنَ الصَّبْرِ. Never has the great ni'mah of sabr like those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them sabr. This hadith recorded in Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim. Seeking patient with the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and staying away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid us from doing it, and being patient with the qadr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the test of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is a great reward. We all know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, وَبَشِّرْ الصَّابِرِينَ. There are too many ayah that we can say this is sufficient for us to reflect upon. But they give the glad tidings to those who are being patient. إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. How many of us were tested with calamity? They lost their loved one. How many of us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test them with a temptation or calamity or fitna or a disease or sickness and being patient with it? وَأَكْمَلُ الصَّابِرِينَ أَيُّوب عَلَيْهِ السَّلَامِ. The most one has complete patience was Ayyub alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test him with a major disease. And he was patient for it. Until he raised his hand to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbi inni massani al-dur wa anta arhamur rahimin. I was afflicted with harm. Ya Allah, you are the most merciful one. So being patient is take you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with all of this obedience, all this ibadah. You disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala being sabir, being a abdun, have patience with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive your sins. إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward those who have patience without quantity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do you have no limitation of reward? This is the sabr. نِعْمَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِّنَ الْعَطَايَا الَّتِي يُعْطِيهَا اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى لِعِبَادِهِ. Among the blessings of gift, or the most important gift that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give, is to be a patient. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, whomsoever seek patient, he or she want to be among the patient, yusabbiruhu Allah. So you have to seek it. You have to ask for it. Allahumma ij'alna min as-sabirin. Oh Allah, make us among the patient one. Allahumma ij'alni sabira. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, usbiru wa sabiru wa rabitu. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. Who believe, be patient, وَصَابِرُوا, and stick to it. وَرَابِطُوا, hold to it. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ, and do goodness. Why? That you may gain the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. اللهم ارحمنا برحمتك الواسعة. اللهم ارحمنا برحمتك الواسعة. اللهم ارحمنا برحمتك الواسعة. اللهم اجعلنا من الصابرين لك الشاكرين لنعمتك الراضين بقضائك. اللهم اجعلنا من الصابرين في الدنيا والآخرة. اللهم اجعلنا من الصابرين على بلائك وعلى امتحانك. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us patience and have mercy upon all of us and have mercy among those who passed away from among us. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to shower all of us His mercy and to shower all of His forgiveness. اللهم اجعلنا من التوابين. اللهم اجعلنا من المستغفرين. واجعلنا يا ربنا ممن رحمتهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة تنهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
Allah has blessed one of the sisters, inshallah ta'ala, and he guided here to accept Islam. So please bear with us after the salah to witness one of the great matters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided us all and make us strength on the steadfastness of his guidance. Allahumma ameen. Stow straight in line, please, for the gaps.
Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين أم حسبتم أن تدخلوا الجنة ولما يعلم الله الذين صبروا جاهدوا منكم ويعلم الصابرين ولقد كنتم تمنون الموت من قبل أن تلقوه فقد رأيتموه وأنتم تنظرون الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين يا بني أقم الصلاة وأمر بالمعروف وانه عن المنكر واصبر على ما أصابك واصبر على ما أصابك إن ذلك من عزم الأمور الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام